guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, and I am Jahziah, and today I'm going to be doing a video on how to survive the 6th grade. Now, I just finished the 6th grade, but I didn't, like, necessarily finish it because of the virus, but I was in there for long enough to, like, know everything, and hopefully we're going back to school this year. I really do believe we are, or, like, they do half and half. One half is we're on campus, and the other half of the day we're maybe online. I don't know what they're going to do, but I just still decided to make this video because I felt like, why not? First video, how to survive the 6th grade. Great way to start off. So, I basically typed up everything. There are 17 tips, and like some of them kind of, so basically tip number, before we get into this video, make sure you go follow me on Instagram at jahziahd and on TikTok at jahziah.defoe. I believe that's how it is. Okay, so tip number one, smell good and have good hygiene. Now, my friend, she made a video on the same thing, on how to survive the 6th grade, and she said that the number one rule was smell good, so I said, why not put that in? I think her channel is Zai's Life. I think, I might just write it, like, right around here somewhere, whatever. So, you want to smell good and have good hygiene, because you don't want to go in walking and just smell like you just came from out of the ocean, haven't showered in like 6 days. That is a very bad way to start off. Just like, if you can, shower the night before or shower the morning of the first day of school, because that'll really help. Okay, two, don't go in with the mindset that everything is going to be easy. One, the work can get very, very overwhelming. And two, not everybody's going to be nice, so not everybody's going to be easy to deal with. So, yeah, you just can't really go in with the mindset that everything is going to be easy. Three, know your people in the group that you like to hang out with, which basically means that when you're going in to middle school, you don't really know anybody. So you might know some of your friends from your old school, and you might not know some. So, like, what I'm saying is when you walk in and if you don't really know anybody, what you're going to have to do is, like, you can kind of, like, get to know people, see which people you like to hang out with, and don't get so close to people, because one mistake that you can really make is getting so close to people that, because some people can be really fake in middle school, or they'll leave you for other people. So, or they'll talk about you behind your back, because I've experienced some of that, but I've learned not to get too close to people, because if you get too close to people, then when they decide to leave you, you're going to be, like, really, really, really sad, and you're going to be crying, and it's going to be like what you see on YouTube when people go through a breakup and stuff like that. Four, don't get distracted. Have any, because, like, I have some friends that were in, that went to my same elementary school that are in this school now, and they have boyfriends. I don't really know what their love life was like, but, like, yada, yada, yada. And another thing that can get you distracted is, I don't really know. Next. Five, don't act like a little kid. You're in middle school now. You gotta grow up. You can't go running around the hall screaming. Definitely. Don't want to do that, because, like, you will get sent to the office and stuff like that. I mean, like, there's still office and you will still get in trouble and stuff like that. Six, do your work. Education is the key. That's exactly why you're going to school. You're not going to school just to socialize and meet friends and stuff like that. So, yeah, do your work. Seven, if you like school activities, like, have at least one teacher that you like and that likes you back. Because, like, let's say you want to try out for track and you need a teacher signature or something like that. And you also have to behave, because your teacher will not sign that if you're misbehaving. So, yeah. Because I'm thinking about trying out for a sport 7th grade. Because I wanted to try out for a sport. They had so many auditions. But I was doing drama. So, we had, after-school practices on the exact same days that there was trials going on. I even wanted to try out for majorette. Missed it. So, yeah, I'm going to take 7th grade year to actually, really figure out what's going on with all these sports and things like that, because I really, really want to know them. Okay, 8. You want to most likely have an agenda, because you need to be able to keep track of your work. Because you're going to get a lot of work. Because you have, some schools have 6 classes, some schools have 8 classes. The school that I go to has 8 classes. And some days, all of my teachers give me homework. Well, we have split days. So one day you have 4 classes, the other day you have the next 4 classes. So that's basically, really. Sorry. So yeah, that's how that goes. And they at Walmart, before school starts in the back to school season, they have adorable planners. And if you go to Michael's, which is a crafting store, then they have some adorable stickers that you can put in there. And the sticker books have themes. I got the Boss Babe one, because especially agendas, they keep you really, really organized. And the stickers are so cute. But, some of the agendas are kind of, girly. So, yeah. If you're not into, girly stuff, you could still go and check them out. But you got to see which ones you'd like. 9. When you have big projects, get it done before the due date. If you have a project and your teacher gives you a week to do it. Let's say they give it to you on Friday. Not Friday. They give it to you on Monday and it's due Friday. I suggest that you plan it, plan what you want to do, get the project done, and have it done before the due date, and have some extra days before the due date time, so you can, look over it and everything like that. I don't know, has there been any project that I've waited till last minute to do? I don't think so, because I had my agenda, and my agenda kept me organized, so I knew what things I had to do, and I wrote down in my agenda what I had to do. So yeah, 10, try to look good. If you're not into this fashion type thing, then I guess you can don't really have to worry about that. But even if you go to a uniform school, which I do, and the shirts are very limited. We can't even wear red shirts. We can only wear white, black, gold, and navy blue. And the bottoms are limited too. We can't even wear jeans, but shoes, I really, really, really like shoes. So I have plenty of shoes that match with lots of tops that I have. So that also helped me with matching. And if you're not into buying all these expensive shoes, you really don't need to do that. Jewelry complements well. You can go to the hair store and things like that, and you can get belts for $5. I'm wearing a belt now. Hold on, let me see. It's navy blue. That's just a navy blue. It's not really navy blue in my hair, but there's navy blue in my shoes because I'm wearing Fila's. So, yeah. That's that. Okay, and 11. Okay, so closer into the year, you'll realize what people are fake to you and what people are not. And you don't want to react to fake people so badly. If they're fake, then you just, you distance yourself from them. Because you don't really want to, start a big argument and everything. And I think this is 12. Don't try to get attention from the older years. I mean, you can have friends that are 7th and 8th graders. You can hang out with them. But, don't try and get attention from them. It's not worth it. It's really not worth it. 13. Don't be desperate to be popular. So in some schools there might be popular people, and and some schools that aren't. In my school, you just have your clique or, like, the people that you hang out with, and you just hang out with them. There isn't really a name on them. There's well-known, where a lot of people know you, or you hang out with a lot of people, or you have different cliques that you're in. But, like, if you're in a school where people like, range you from popular to unpopular, don't be desperate to be popular. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's not that worth it. Like, in those middle school movies, you see what happened to the popular people. I don't know if it happens in real life, but, like, I don't really think it's worth it. I mean, like, being popular won't put anything on you in the future. It doesn't go on a resume and help you get into college, so there's no reason to be popular. 14. Be yourself. Yeah, basically, be yourself. A lot of people tell you that, I'm pretty sure. And the best way to make friends is to be yourself, because if you're not yourself, then you may become friends with somebody that isn't really like you, or that may be prone to... If you're a really good person and you act pop... Okay, well, let's say you're a really nice person and the popular people are mean or something, and you try to act mean in order to become popular like them. I mean, like, that's really not being yourself, and it's not really worth it. I really don't think popularity is, like, a good thing or something. I think this is 15. Be kind to the older year and your year. So some of these I am getting from off of Instagram. Their account is Sweet Society, 3 Y's at the end. So yeah, that's where I'm getting some of these at the end. And it's the one that I just said, I think was 15. Be kind to the older year and your year. Which is basically, so don't try and get attention from them, but like I said, you can still be friends with them and be nice. And you see some people, like, you'll know which ones you'll like to hang out with and not hang out with, I guess you can say that. I don't really know. Because I was in drama, and drama is all grades. Well, you have to audition to get in, and it's all grades, and we went on, like, lots of overnight field trips and things like that to, like, stay in district and stuff. So that's how I made some friends that are 7th and 8th grade, and most of them are really, really nice. You know what? All of them are really, really nice, especially the ones in drama. The ones outside of school, I mean, outside of drama, they're really nice, too. So, yeah. Because I rode, like, a 4:30 bus after school, which is basically the college activity bus. So, I met some older years there, and they're really nice. I don't know what number this is. Focus on your grades, as they are very important. You want to get into college, you need good grades. You want to get into a good high school, you need good grades. If you're not going to college, it doesn't really matter. You still need good grades, because you don't want to be on the streets. You want to get a good job, and I'm pretty sure they're going to look at your grades, and you want a good record, and being bad, if you're disrespectful or something like that, then that can get you kicked out of class, and if you're kicked out of class, then you can get bad grades, and that's not what you want. Let's see, last one, make sure you're in a good environment all the time, I guess. I mean, like, school is a good environment. But, like, make sure you're hanging out with the right people. I guess you can say that. So, yeah. I believe that is it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on those post notifications so you get notified every time I post a video. And I'm not very consistent with videos, so I'm working on that. So, yeah, we're going to see how this goes. So, I hope you enjoyed my video. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at jahziahd. And follow me on TikTok at jahziahd_defoe. Love you guys. Mwah. Bye.